Hey team, Tim here from RaceCraft. Welcome to today's members webinar. Today, we're going to be talking all about setting up live logger math. What I mean by that is math channels that we are computing inside of our data logger rather than inside the analysis project itself. Now, we're going to get to that really soon, but before we do that, let's go through a little bit of a pre-show. And as we always do, I'll update you guys a little bit with what's been happening around here in our workshop and what we've got going on around the place. So jumping across to my laptop screen here, we've got another shot of a car that you guys have seen quite a lot in recent times, which is our SR20 powered GT86 endurance racing car. So one of the projects that a lot of our regular viewers will be familiar with is that we are going through quite a few upgrades as far as the cooling system at the moment, and specifically really just developing a lot of the ducting and everything that's going on in that car. Now, as with everything with cars like this, packaging is a massive challenge. And this car is certainly no different to that. We are having to take quite a few compromises to manage to fit and package everything around some of the factory style equipment that we've got in the car. But over here, what we've got, looking at the front left corner of the car, you can see here, this is the front splitter and under tray that we've got attached to the car that's currently being mocked up on there. I'll go through a couple of different views, but essentially looking from the side here, we've got in this black section here is just a little bit of the side of the engine oil cooler, which is packaged there in the front left. We've got the inlet duct packaged on the front, and then this little foam section here, this is the beginnings of an outlet duct. Now, for anyone that has been watching a few of these webinars recently and have seen a few of the updates, you guys will have seen we've gone through a few different iterations of designs for these. If I go through a couple of different pictures here, you'll see exactly how these are working. So essentially we've got the inlet to the intercooler and radiator through this section. We've got our brake cooling down here, and this is the inlet for the engine oil cooler. There's essentially a fully symmetric version of that on the other side of the car, which is to cool the transmission oil cooler, which on this car is actually using the same style and size of oil cooler for both the engine and transmission. This, you can see here, we've got this duct, which is coming out on a little bit of an awkward angle, but as I said, going back to that first sort of view here, we've got a certain amount of room we need to leave for the tyres here. Obviously the tyres need to be able to rotate as they steer, as well as go up and down, so there's a certain amount of clearance we need to leave in there as well. Obviously, we want to have that air coming out in the most intelligent angle as possible, so ideally going rearwards. That's going to be really difficult to do with the way we've got everything packaged in there. You can see where basically the front of the bumper is somewhere in this zone here, so there's not a lot of room to package the oil cooler or any of the ducting. So it's really typical of what a lot of people come into contact with when they're packaging or having cooling problems on something that's based on a road car. It's really difficult to fit all of the coolers and the package and all the ducting that goes with them. I think I've got one more view here. Yeah, so this just gives like another perspective of the mocked up ducting and everything on here. So essentially you can see the air will come in here to the oil cooler and then exit out the side through the bumper. The current idea with everything is that the bumper itself will be cut away in this section. So essentially there's going to be a cutaway here with the rest of the bumper kind of, if I can draw that properly, kind of looking like that. So the idea is that the bumper will attach from the front of the car and sort of just sit up hard against that duct. The idea here is to try and make it as practical as possible to have the bumper on and off. You don't want to be unbolting things on and off and having to take ducts on and off the car to get that bumper off, because getting that bumper off quickly can be really important if you need to get in there and service something. And certainly serviceability is probably a pretty underrated part of building race cars. It's probably one of the things that tends to get left to last. And you end up having something that's quite difficult to work on or slow to work on, which really can take a lot of the fun out of it and also cost you a lot of time. So that's one of the things, one of the elements we're trying to take into account as we go through and sort of revise a whole lot of the build aspects of this car. As far as other things that have been going on around the place, in addition to me being full-time here at RaceCraft, I also do a little bit of freelance race engineering still. This is a shot of us. I was at a test last weekend at one of the local New Zealand racetracks. This is an Audi LMS GT3 car, so the car's just had a new livery applied for this season. We've got, you can see, a few sets of tyres laid out here for the test. It was a really productive test day. It was the first test day for myself for this year. It's really great getting the opportunity to run cars like this that are I guess relatively sophisticated, good data systems, lots of sensors on the cars, good level of drivers, and we're looking forward to getting started into the season, getting running proper. Here's just another shot of that car. I think the livery looks really great. It was my first time seeing it when we got to the track the other day, but I'm really looking forward to getting stuck into the season and getting some more miles on this car and doing lots more learning as we go. So that's it for what's been going on around the shop. There was a couple of things I wanted to bring up as far as stuff we had in our socials. So I think it was yesterday I put up this post of it's a taped up Racelogic time delta screen. So all it is, for anyone that's not familiar, essentially it's a little screen that the driver can use to show the gain and loss function, so how you're going on track relative to the reference lap. And the thing I thought was quite funny about this is that someone's actually got this thing completely taped up. They've got a whole lot of electrical tape to tape it up. Now what's actually going on there is, and this is something you quite often see, is that once people get used to using that time delta function, which for anyone who's not sure is essentially just a way to track yourself relative to the reference lap, so it's giving you a real-time feedback for what your time difference is relative to the reference lap, which is ideally a lap that's faster than what you're currently capable of doing. What you often find is once people start using this, and it is a really valuable and useful tool, what you can get people fixating on it to the point where they actually start driving worse because they're fixating so much on the time delta, they start to forget some other basics, whether it's throttle or braking technique or turn in points or their braking markers. Being too distracted on that time delta screen can be a pretty bad thing. Now, in my experience, what you often have, and it depends a little bit on driver preference, but what I've done in the past is had it so that we have in qualifying, and sometimes even in the race, we turn that time delta off for the driver. So it's usually just a case of sending a new configuration to the dash or to the logger, depending on what your setup is. So they're only using that time delta in practice as you're tuning the car and looking to tune up their driving as you go throughout the race weekend. But then when it gets to qualifying, we often turn that off to stop it being such a distraction, to stop them fixating so much on the time delta and actually allow them to concentrate on their driving. Because by that point in the weekend, they should already have a pretty good idea of what they're trying to do with the car, where we're trying to improve it, where we're trying to improve their driving, and having that time delta can be a little bit of a distraction. So this was a shot, the Racecraft photographers got recently from a recent track day that I thought was actually quite amusing seeing it taped up like this. It's certainly a valid way of achieving the same thing of getting rid of that distraction, albeit a pretty simple way to do it as well. One of the other things I wanted to bring up was a post that came up, has got a little bit of action on the Racecraft forums recently. So as always, the forums are getting definitely quite a lot of attention. There's a lot of people posting really, really quality questions and really quality feedback. And then now this is a question about from one of our members, Dimitrios, on a brake upgrade. So I'll let you guys read that through in your own time. That is under forum, general discussion and brake upgrade. Essentially, Dimitrios there was asking about some basic ideas about brake upgrades. He was telling us a little bit about what system he's got, what sort of directions he can go with, and people were giving their feedback, which I thought there was some really quality feedback going on in there. This is pretty typical of brake upgrades. The theory is really useful, but ultimately the practical elements and people's experience definitely come into play as far as making sure everything's sized properly and giving yourself plenty of options for different pad compounds and everything like that. So if you guys are interested in a discussion like that, I suggest you head over to the forums and check that out for yourself. Now, as far as upcoming courses, our race driving fundamentals course is currently in the later stages of production, so that is slated for release by the end of this quarter. That's currently having the last part of the filming done for that course at the moment, and I think that's definitely going to be of value and of interest to a lot of current and future Racecraft members. I think it's something that's certainly missing from our course repertoire at the moment, and I'm looking forward to seeing that on the website because I think that's going to be a really great resource for a lot of people. Okay guys, that's good. The end of our pre-show. I'll be back in a second and we'll get into the main topic of today's webinar on the math systems in your data logger. If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.